There were flowers, there were haka, there were vigils. As New Zealanders and the world grappled with an unfathomable attack on our little country at the bottom of the South Pacific.
This is something that wasn't meant to happen here in New Zealand. You know, we're just a sleepy old nation, nothing happens here.
We, New Zealand, we were not a target because we are a safe harbour for those who hate. We were not chosen for this act of violence because we condone racism, because we are an enclave for extremism. We were chosen for the very fact that we are none of these things.
The country breathed a sigh of relief when the gunman was found not to be a New Zealander, and the sentiment, "this is not who we are," echoed across the country. But New Zealand historian and anthropologist Dame Anne Salmond is calling it out.
I thought, well, that's one way of letting yourself off the hook, you know, saying someone else's problem, you know, it's Australia's problem, or... And I don't think, given our history as a country, that you can get away with that.
Since the arrival of colonial settlers almost 200 years ago, New Zealand has seen many dark days, including the brutal land wars of the 1800s, which saw the death of several thousand Māori by British forces.
Terrorism for Māori didn't start last week. It was at Waitara, it was at Pukehina, at Ruapekapeka, at Rangiriri, at Rangiawha, at Parihaka, at Ōrākau. And so this has been this underlying theme that's been pervading our country for a long, long time.
Well, I think a lot of people in the comfort zone probably feel that they have confronted those issues through the Waitangi Tribunal, and they've kind of exonerated history through that process. And so there's no need to worry about it anymore.
After World War II, New Zealand received a number of refugees from European countries, and by the 1970s, its Pacific population had increased to 50,000 in just two decades. But recession and rising unemployment saw a government crackdown on illegal overstayers, with 1974 dawn raids on Pacific family homes casting a dark shadow on race relations in New Zealand.
Pacific people understand that experience of moving to another country, and Pacific people who've been here, particularly in the 1970s, understand that experience of being singled out for how they look and what they do, for being different.
Salesa says although experiences with white nationalists is not new, the Christchurch attack was different.
Racism and the work of race has always been essential to what New Zealand is. And we have seen lots of violence, that's colonial violence and imperial violence, that's been directed against Polynesian people, whether it's in New Zealand or in the Pacific. But actually the kind of violence we saw 2 weeks ago was particularly virulent. It was a new kind of violence. You know, it wasn't the first, it wasn't the end of innocence, but it was a scale of violence and an intensity of violence that we hadn't experienced.
But Anjum Rahman of the Islamic Women's Council says the attack came as no surprise. After 5 years lobbying government, politicians, SIS and the Human Rights Commission over concerns for the rise of alt-right in New Zealand and discrimination towards Muslims.
I'm really hoping that whatever inquiry is set up will have a really good look at that and then recommend pathways forward. I think this needs urgent attention, it needs urgent resourcing. However, we recognise that the politicians on the families in Christchurch at the moment, and that needs to happen, and we want to give our government due process to make sure that everything that needs to be done there is done.
Salmond says attitudes must change from government and in the home.
It's hard to make laws against that behaviour. You've got to change people's hearts and their minds. But I think you need the laws too, because there's times when people just step over the mark and they do such harm.
The government is holding an inquiry into the country's security agencies in the wake of Christchurch, and social media giant Facebook has been pressured to remove material which promotes hate. Even the Crusaders rugby team is considering a name change. For Salesa, there has been light in this tragedy.
One of the great outcomes of this terrible situation has been all the New Zealanders, including Pacific New Zealanders, who have actually engaged for the first time with Islam. And they've found it to be quite different, I suspect, to what they thought it would be. And the welcome and connections that have been built in this moment will be enduring. And above all, people have learnt about each other in very powerful ways.